Could there be food compatibility problems with people with sleep apnea or depressed hormone levels? Or and then there's certain exercises you can do without having to wear the mask. Some refuse to, some will.
All of that is meaningful. Mm-hmm. First, you've got to find the thing, and then you know the treatment options become fairly universal.
Right.
So you know there are other things to look at supplement nutrition wise, but basically diet. The one thing I want to talk to you about diet. You know, you and I have talked about diet, and we acknowledge there are many different ways. I've simplified my dietary things so much based on this whole issue of, you know, genetic compatibility and whatever. And I know I'm going to piss off a lot of dietitians out there, and a lot of people are doing personalized.
But you're good with coconut meat, avocado, nuts and seeds, it's got fat, but it's got fibers.
I'm a big believer in medium chain triglycerides, fats, and essential fats.
Look at the South Pacific Islanders. Sure. They eat a lot of coconut, and they get a little heavy because they don't maybe need
but
to exercise.
But they don't get the diseases.
They don't. They have no...
Those are the same way. They're omega-3 rich. There was a study done a while back. I call it the Fat Eskimo Study. That's the Eskimos. But, I mean, they tended to be 50 pounds overweight. Their cholesterol was 50 pounds over. They're generally hypertensive. And they got none of the diseases that we get, you know, as of aging that we get because your omega-3s were so high. So, again, this is kind of voodoo science to a lot of people, but if you fix those kinds of things. My thing with diet is this, regulate your insulin. I don't care if you do it on raw food, veganism, vegetarianism, you know, just make sure you're getting healthy nutrients and regulate your insulin. Keep your insulin levels lower than most people are keeping them, and you will find that whatever diet you choose is extremely healthy.
Now, some people, interestingly enough, let's say their system is highly capable of allowing insulin to do its job, which is basically pushing the sugar into the cells to be utilized and releasing the amino acids, the fatty acids, and so forth. But some of the bodybuilders actually use it as a growth factor.
It's a growth hormone.
They use it to build up muscle density.
It is a growth hormone. That's playing with fire in a sense.
Right.
But you know, if you know what you're doing, you can do that. I don't do that, but I know there are people who are very good at doing that, at playing with those, hormonal manipulations. I think you have to also look at, bodybuilding in a sense of the age range and the desire. And, for me, what I've found as I've gotten older, and I went through a phase where I was 50 pounds heavier and I was pretty solid. I think for as we age, and again, this is not saying that every phase of life is the same, but as we age, I think leaner is better, and to some degree, lighter is better.
And yoga's okay.
And yoga's okay. Yoga's great.
Yeah.
Yoga's phenomenal. I mean, I think we should be as we get older, we should be spending more of our time working over our fascial tissue and our muscle attachments. I think that's the next phase. I'm working on bringing some of those people into our cadres to have them lecture to us about things about fascial health and mobility and how that may impact so many of the things that you and I are trying to do.
Yeah. One of the interesting things is, as scientists or just even as people who are highly passionate about what they do, we're always looking for things that support our belief, right?
True.
So when I read the book Eat and Run by Scott Jurek, and he talks about the barefoot runners and running barefoot, and we were designed to, basically the foot spring, right from the foot to mid to forefoot, where shoes force us with the heel to go heel to toe. And my friend Dr. James Stockson, he talks about barefoot running, and he deals with a lot of alignment problems. And I marvel, and I'm concerned about the number of people with hip problems, knee problems, ankle, and they don't realize the structure. So it may be embarrassing, but I walk around with shoes that have no heels, and these things are, basically water shoes because I couldn't find. There's no shoe company that makes shoes.
Right.
Without that added sole, and it throws out your foundation.
I think you're going to see more and more. The whole barefoot running thing is really interesting to me because I am a distance runner.
Yeah.
And I also have flat feet.
Me
so,
too.
It's very, very difficult. I can walk around in minimalist shoes, no problem. But I haven't gotten to the point where I can run long distances in them yet. But you mentioned about the barefoot, the 4-foot strikeout.
Yeah.
I am a big proponent and disciple of Nicholas Romanov's pose running, which to me is the original of all this. Some of the stuff that's come since chi running, et cetera, they're pretty much patterning what they're doing
after Romanov studies. And you know, the most efficient way to move, especially by running, is exactly that. 4 foot striking, gravity pull, elastic recoil, and really the only effort you're using is hamstring-based effort. And I'm trying to retrain myself to run that way now. Yeah. It's been a very interesting journey.
Well, you have to sacrifice the ego a little bit because your times will be a little slower.
At first.
But
at first.
As I continue to progress, I notice, you know, I'm starting to gradually
it gets easier. Yeah.
And I refuse to wear shoes anywhere now, even though my colleagues will say, you're going to go on stage without shoes? That this looks silly. And I'm like, my health. Yeah. And this is a choice.
Just remember Ringo's story.
What did he say?
Well, Ringo went into a restaurant. 30 or 40 years ago, soon after the Beatles dissolved, everybody knew who he was.
Yeah.
And he didn't have a jacket on. And so they said, I'm sorry, Mr. Story, you can't eat here. You need to have a jacket on. So he came back with a jacket and tie, and nobody noticed he had bare feet. So no one's looking that closely.
Well, now that I've pointed it out, I was going to be looking. I'm in trouble.
Yeah,
you know?
But, you know, I think you're going to see. I think you're a pioneer, and I think you're going to see a lot more people doing that. I brought my minimalist shoes with me. I haven't gotten to them. They happen to be neon blue, so I probably won't be wearing them on stage. But
well, that's why I went to black. I found it a surf shop. Literally, you know, the shoes that you go out on the surf area.
It's a good tip.
And instead of having to pay for those toe shoes that are, you know, 70, 80 bucks a crack, these are $20, XL.
It's a very
simple thing.
Thank you for that tip. I learned something. I'm going to get a pair and I'm going to start wearing them.
Yeah.
Seriously.
We'll probably be the only two.
On stage
we'll go on stage and people go, what is this? What is this?
Well, I just wear a long cuff, you know.
No one notices until you point it out.
Exactly. That's a good thing.
If they were neon blue, I guess it would be a problem.
And I think that, you know, I look forward to the day when you and I can discuss astrology as one of the tenets of what we are.
Yeah.
And I think, you know, you and I should, as pioneers, bring these people in. Mm-hmm. You know, I've got some proponents of, you know, the whole anatomy trains and fascial system people I knew there I would like to bring in. It's been incredible in terms of improving the way I move. Mm-hmm. And, you know, movement, again, we're trying to preserve our ability to move as long as possible. And, you know, what's more deadly than being sedentary? There's almost nothing more. I mean, you want to see somebody who's going to die, go into a hospital, somebody who can't move. You know, we talk about the 100% mortality, nobody gets out of here alive. They're hitting 90, 98%. You know? So mobility and the ability to move throughout the rest of your life is critical.
Critical.
And it's not one of the big tenets yet.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it will be, thanks to us, right?
Thanks to us.
Super.
How can they get a hold of you?
My website is the best way. I have a very active customer service and just anybody wants to ask a question, interaction. That's www.drdavesbest.com. I have a blog, drdaveunleashed.com, where I say all kinds of things that inflame all kinds of people, but they're the truth, damn it. So, you know, that's where you find out what I'm really, and
sure.
I, of course, I publish a semi-daily newsletter, usually 2-3 times a week, where I inform people what I'm doing. So I'm easy to get a hold of.
Excellent. Thank you, Dr. Dave.
Thank you. And it's wonderful to be with you, as always. And I look forward to sharing soon again.
So we'll
really
do
exciting
it.
Stuff we're doing.
Let's follow up. Let's motivate those people to do and be their best.
Thank you. Thanks for your time.